to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding.
Oh, get home tomorrow and everything is good tonight, I want you to call the people that should be here tonight and tell them to come out of church tomorrow night. Y'all heard what I said? Call the people that you know should have been here tonight and tell them they need to be out on tomorrow night. Is it all right? Haggai chapter number 2, starting at verse number 3. When you have it, please say amen. Now, I didn't come here to preach anything brand new. Bishop Frazier is a beast of a preacher.
Amen. Amen.
Let me teach you. I said, Bishop Frazier is a beast of a teacher. The pastor is one of the most unpaid jobs in the world.
Amen.
I said, the pastor is the most underpaid job in the world. Because all the hell
that's it.
Y'all put us through.
Glory.
Why y'all quiet? I'm all right. What the hell y'all put us through? You can't pay us enough to carry out this responsibility. And here's the funny part about this. Nobody here that would work and don't want to get paid.
Right.
Amen.
Can I see the hand of anybody that would work for you? Answer your hands. And when you're on a job, I'm preaching, I'm going to get to the text. When you're on a job, after you worked a year or so, you want a raise. Whether it's 1 cent, whether it's 15 cent, 25%, 25 cent, you want your raise. However, the pastor is the only job where the same way we came in, maybe the same way we leave.
Wow.
We pass it 20 years, 25 years, 30 years, and someone in their mind still think that y'all doing something. Why y'all quiet? All right. Haggai chapter number 2. This ain't going too well.
It
ain't going too well. This is 2020, and I came into this year with a new attitude. Tolerance level for foolishness
is done.
Was left in 2019.
That's it.
Yes.
Amen.
This year, in fact, this next decade, we're not playing church. We're not playing with people that don't want to listen. Chapter number 2, verse number 3 to verse number 9. Do you have it? Do you have it? You don't have it on the screen, right? Who is left among you that saw this house in its her first glory? And how do we see it now? Is it not in your eyes a comparison of it as nothing? You know, be strong, dear brother, say the Lord of hosts, the Lord of hosts, say the Lord, be strong, O Joshua, son of Jehosh, the high priest, and be strong, O ye people of the land, say the Lord, and the work, for I am with you, say the Lord of hosts, according to the word that I have come up with you. You came out of Egypt, so my spirit remain among you, fear ye not. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once in a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land. And I will shake all nations, and desire all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, saith the Lord of hosts. And God's word is blessed. And God will say, amen.
Amen.
Today's text, the book of Haggai, just short two chapters. Haggai, a prophet of God. You don't call him a major prophet, but a minor prophet, because he didn't say much. But what he said was powerful. Haggai has a task because he is in the process of trying to rebuild the temple. He's trying to get the church back to where it was. There's a theme for this revival called reset. He's trying to reset. He's trying to get the people's mind right. He's trying to let them know that you must put first things first. You can't no longer take care of yourself and the house of God go to ruin. You must take care of the house of God. While you're quiet. He says to them, he says, listen, in chapter 1, he says, I have a problem because y'all looking good. You got new hairstyles. You got nice manicures. You got nice weave and wear your wigs. Red bottoms, blue bottoms, fatal bottoms. Got nice sneakers, Jordans, Nikes, and got nice sweatshirts and nice ties and nice bow ties, and yet something is missing in the house. Tell you, something missing inside the house. He's trying to get the minds of the people correct. I was sharing in these passages that here, the bishops and the apostles that are here, they will tell you that in the 52 weeks of preaching, maybe 45 to 46 weeks of us preaching, we're trying to encourage you to stay a believer. We come to church every Sunday, a Sunday after Sunday, and basically we say the same thing. We just give it a different title, we bind it with different scripture, just so you can be restored, just so you can be renewed. We spend about 46 weeks talking to the believer to believe.
Yeah, man.
We spend so much time, and they're not going to be talking about believing. Then we got to talk to you about giving. Because church folk have become some of the most cheapest, fruitless. Y'all quiet. The cheapest, fruitless people I have ever seen in my whole entire life. Tell Pastor Stanton, listen, tithe, 10% of your increase, 10% of your increase, not your job, but your increase, 10, y'all, what? 10% of your increase must go to God. And you say, I can't afford to do that, so you don't give your tithe, but you're still broke. You're holding back your money, but you're still broke.
Yeah.
Things are going to get
Insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, looking for different results. If you try everything and everything fails, try tithing. Time now where church is no longer the way it used to be.
Wow.
Church folk is having a problem with church.
Yeah.
I told my church bishop, I don't care what they said about the church. Some of the stuff they said about the church is true. We got some liars. We got some backbiters.
See?
And do overtime and they ask 1 hour services, campuses, and satellite church, and they do all in 1 hour. Where I'm not knocking it to work for them, it worked for them. But when you cry out to God, you want more.
Because I remember back in the day, we used to praise God till we ceased. Now, Now,
they're all being church the way it used to be. Remember that we didn't have to cry you and plot you. You was excited. You remember when you first got saved? Can't nobody keep you from church? What happened? When you first got saved and you was loving Jesus, what happened? What happened to your zeal? Yeah. What happened to your love? Yeah. He did for the well of the wool. Healed you. Yes.
Right.
What happened, believers? Yeah. Where did we go wrong? Pastors are listening to their members. Yeah. Members are saying, Pastor, we don't need to do all this and that's okay. People come into our church, I've got the Lord sent me here to help you lead it. Because sheep don't help the shepherd, shepherd help the sheep.
Yeah.
You ain't coming here to help me, I'm here to help you.
That's right.
What did we go wrong, Bishop? Why the church is not packed tonight? Because pastors got tired. They got frustrated. So when the pastor is burnt out, when the pastor is angry, when the pastor don't want to do it no more, they shut church down. The Catholic church is open 24 hours. And the believing church is closed. And when we're here, we're not here long because you got work in the morning. But when you were saved, wasn't saved, you party all night long. And sit when I got up, didn't take a bath, didn't take a shower. Went back to work and worked all day long and did a little hit and went back to partying. Now you saved. And some of y'all said, you better hurry up because I got to go. I'm hungry. What happened? I can scream and holler all night long if I want to, but I don't feel like tonight that this is going to be the message that y'all signed with, because a lot of people yelling at you. And you're emotional. You feel good, but nothing's changed. What happened to you? Actually, so what happened to me? What happened to me? Where my love at? Where's my commitment at? What happened to the church? This would be a time when people were walking out of the church, demons were walking out of the church, the power of God was so thick.
Yes.
That the Holy Ghost will put them under arrest.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost will restrain them.
Yes.
But now people are walking in our churches with guns.
Amen.
Where the power at?
Right.
Where the praying mothers? Where are the faithful deacons? Where are the saved ushers at? People got titles with no power. People got titles. You want to be promoted, but you ain't got no power.
Yeah.
You want elevation, but you haven't spent time with God. You don't come to power class. How can you be saved and don't come to power class?
Come on, the
someone didn't speak to you. Maybe they didn't see you.
Come on.
And maybe if they didn't speak to you, why didn't you speak to them?
Come on.
Why y'all crying? Here we go tomorrow. We're like, we better tomorrow. Like, this is ice. This is ice. Is it anybody never watched? Is it anybody now?
Yes.
That knows about holding on to the words of the altar.
Yes.
Wow.
And not moving until God changes things.
Yes.
Anybody never being steadfast, unmovable?
Yes.
Happy that God will stand, keep on standing. We must get to talk about sin. We tell people, stop that shacking.
That's why. That's
not that lying. We scared to tell more. Because they might leave the wall into the pastors that don't preach the gospel. Or Pagan had a deal because he wanted the temple to be rebuilt. But the mind frame of the people had to remember where they come from. We forgot what worked. Y'all remember Bishop got the clothes. You women had to wear chapel caps.
Right.
And now y'all got smart to where I gotta cover my head. Cause my pastor is my covering. Or my husband is my covering.
Right.
And that's what I'm good, but you ain't submissive.
Come on, man. Listen.
I just lost out of church.
Come on.
You're not submissive to leadership. So you might as well put it back on your head. Because you're not listening to authority.
Jesus.
You're not hearing your pastor.
My.
So you won't never listen to your husband.
My
God. You're out of order. I'm close.
Go.
I'm all right right here. I'm going back to my life.
Jesus.
Because this will be what I was about. Because I want to make y'all think when y'all leave. That young man, he says, stop. Because this is not the year to be disobedient.
No.
This is a year of obedience.
Yeah.
This is a year that God wants to do something. Watch what the text says. The Bible says, go to verse number 4. Can you go to verse number 4 on the screen? I can see the wall. Verse number 4, it says, everybody, it says, listen, you need all the people, man. Say the Lord of hosts, work for I am with you, say the Lord of hosts. Yeah. Say God's with me.
God is with me.
Go to verse 4. Yeah. Go to verse 4. It says, according to the word that I covenant with you when you came out of Egypt. So God will say, listen, you covered already. Don't have no uniform. something to think about. What you looking for? How do I know that you're part of this army? How do I know, even the black Israelites, you can tell who they are? Or here we are, black Pentecostals. What's our uniform? Why are you so quiet about it? The Lord told me, if you want to reset, if you want to restore, you got to go back to what worked. You got to watch the text. Listen, verse 6. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once in a little while, and I will shake the heaven. So what you say, why someone help y'all with those that didn't understand what he's saying? If you keep my covenant, if you remember the former things, I will tell you in a little while.
Right.
Because there's some
Israel, to God's unchanging hand, say it!
God didn't begin what he said. He said, whatever I say, it cannot return back to me, but it must accomplish that which I set out to do. Lift those hands and upgrade. Is there anybody here left? That's what I'm talking now. Is anybody here left that remembers the former?
Yes.
Yes. I must confess, he said it's a normal lie. We grew up under abuse.
That's right.
Yes. Our pastors abused us. Are y'all quiet?
Amen.
They
come on.
I mean, y'all know what embarrassment is.
Yeah, come on.
That you've been embarrassed.
Yeah, buddy.
We grew up, we were sat down.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got this. Black get back to the days where we honor the men and women of God.
Yes.
I'm disturbed that when I said your pastor's a great pastor, y'all quiet. That's church hurt. Y'all around talking about, they talk, that ain't no church hurt. Y'all want to know real church hurt? Church hurt don't come from the pews. Church will come from the pulpit.
Bye.
Withholding nothing.